don't wait for things to be perfect out here. Don't wait for things to be perfect out here. You leave in here. You leave there and go be in here. Because when your attention is again focused inside your own self, the attachments, the pull, will weaken. Whenever you are established again in your own neutrality, your own presence, everything becomes secondary. They can be there, but they don't have commanding power. Just there. If freedom and liberation are already what I am, why do I delay it and keep myself out of joy by continuing mental attachments to the last two people that I know in my heart are not real? Alana, again? Did I say Alana? Oh, so it's finito? Oh, okay, come. If freedom and liberation are already, and you underline already, are already what I am, why do I delay it and keep myself out of joy by continuing mental attachments to the last two people I know in my heart are not real? My mind has a difficult time breaking this habit. I wish to be free now. Thank you. But you see, your letter start if. You see? If so, if you knew it, because you say, if freedom and liberation are already what I am. So I'm taking the if out. Freedom and liberation are already what I am. Put it back. If freedom and liberation are already what I am. But it's not enough that I put my finger over the if and say freedom and liberation are already what I am if that conviction is not there. How will the conviction be there? And if the conviction is there, then the rest will be automatically taken care of.
It's the 5% you talked about the other day. You know, holding back the 5%.
Yes.
Why do we do that?
Yes. More or less, how do we come to do this? Because in our natural mind, this will not be, it will not, it doesn't recognize this. It won't recognize this in the true state. Nothing will overpower you enough to say, this is going on for me. So how did it come to be that you being the truth, I am starting like that. Some people won't start like that. But I have to start like that and tell you. How comes being already the truth, what is complete, that something then fell into the state where it's holding on to something it knows is not true? And what I can say about it is that because somehow we have this potential to identify with the body and then somehow believe the conditioning that arises around the body to be truthful about who we are. This is the thing. So we are under some kind of an altered state, and it's in this altered state that all these things become more potent, because then you believe I am this person, and then you see another body as another person. It might seem that, what are you saying here? Of course there are other persons. course there are other persons. I am one person, that one is another person, and I know even more different because I am a male person, that's a female person, even. You see? So what are we saying to say this thing? Like throughout the day, in all your interactions, are you strongly in the conviction you're a woman behind all your thinking? Is your thinking feminine? Or does it move out of these contexts? So none of it is really settled. You're not constantly thinking as a woman. Sometimes it's completely neutral, it has nothing to do with your gender at all, isn't it? So these things are not stable. That when we identify with the body and with sense of personality and the distinction of being a unique entity, a unique person, then the sense of other people become more sharp for you also. And then duality is at its most potent expression. And in your natural mind, it will not trouble you. Some people, if they look at the flower, then they lose their sense of self. If somebody speaks with them, then they lose their sense of being present very quickly. And with others, they can be with 1,000 people and it makes no alteration inside their being. So that capacity is in everyone. That potential is in everybody. First starting with the feeling of being me. So there comes with that a kind of self-consciousness, a psychological self-consciousness, where you're on your best behavior, you're constantly feeling that you have to be aware of how you are. Like many people, they're perfectly fine, and you put a camera in front of them and they start to do kind of things like this. And the camera maybe has no film in it, but just put the camera and already, or something, because you start to feel self-conscious and then you start to pose. And many times it seems, with a sense of ego, we are posing. So when we meet another being, we feel we have to be a certain way. And so we become tired of this needing to be something else. And we imagine that the other people expect you to be this. But that's not necessarily true. Maybe they'll just like you to be yourself, so that they can be themselves with you, isn't it? But we imagine that they require from you to be what we imagine they're projecting you to be. And it just goes on. It goes on like that. When two people came to see me in London, they were from the same place in Dublin. And one came first, we had a beautiful meeting, one-to-one in those days, and very quiet, very still. Then the second appointment came a bit early and overlapped, and it was raining outside. So I said, okay, come in. So this woman came in, and then she said, hi, how are you? You like a cup of tea? I go put the kettle on. I'm in the kitchen making the thing. I hear chick, 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 chick. And I didn't like it. So I came back in with my two cups, not looking very happy. What you talking about? First one say, well, actually, after our talk, I just wanted to be quiet. I just wanted to be quiet. And then she came in the room, and I recognized her from my own town. So I said, how are you doing? You know, and she says, oh, fine, fancy seeing you here, kind of stuff. And then ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, after a bit. And then I said, what about you? And she said, well, when I came here, I really have had enough of people. And I just wanted to come and just talk, to be with you. And then I was surprised that somebody was here. Then I saw he's from my town. So I said, hi, how are you doing? And then he says, I'm doing fine, how are you? So in the end, two people meet, none of them want to talk. And a conversation is arising between them. Who is having this conversation? Cultural conditioning is having a conversation. Now, what has all got this to do with your letter now?
Last year I was here, same time in January, and you said to me, you're getting very close to something, very close to something big, and you have to push away people, places, and things out of your life for a while. Then you can bring them back in. And that was successful, most of the people and places and things. Mm-hmm. But there are just these two, and it seems as if it's just the ego's subtle way of keeping you back.
I see. Okay. I see. I see. Don't wait for things to be perfect out here. Don't wait for things to be perfect out here. You leave in here. You leave there and go be in here. Because when your attention is again focused inside your own self, the attachments, the pull, will weaken. Whenever you are established again in your own neutrality, your own presence, everything becomes secondary. They can be there, but they have not, they don't have commanding power. Just there. Such is the magnificence of being. But if you're waiting to try and put it right, this power you may not have.
Do you know him?
No.
He's a Vipassana teacher in California. He had a simple sentence, but he said, your mindfulness is not quite strong enough. You have to develop your mindfulness more.
Oh. That's not true. I wouldn't put it like that. What else? Because then it means that you are going to have to develop some mindfulness now. I just say somehow, be aware even of this. Be aware of even this thing that says, okay, you have to do another. Simply just be aware, because awareness is already here. It's not something you have to make happen. You don't have to make awareness happen. You see? You are the awareness itself. But it appears as though the awareness, when it manifests as presence, it needs the body, and somehow this sense of presence gets identified with the body, and then a secondary, like a second entity, come out as the me, the personality, like this. It is also presence, but it's limited presence, conditioned presence. And at a certain point in your life, it begins to squeeze. You don't want to fit, you can't fit into this limited presence. Something once again now to be unlimited again. Then you may call that the pull of spirituality, you can call, or religion, whatever we want to say. Something feels, I am not just this, more than this. And it's returning again to its original being, original place. You see? But if you look to the mind, there will always be another condition to fulfill. Oh yeah, just, you almost forgot this, and you got to go back and tidy up. But all of that is just an idea. You are already the self, and it has no condition.
So a relaxed attention is what I'm hearing you say. Is that?
Relaxed attention.
Yeah, to these things instead of trying.
Yes, yes, yes. Also, what is trying so hard? Is it the self that's trying so hard? Is it the body? It's not the body. Is it the self? And you understand what I mean by the pure self. It's not. What's it? Why is it trying to do anything? It's simply here. It is in perfect equanimity within itself. So something is trying, is the idea you have of who you are is trying to do something. It's just an idea. Your self-image is trying to accomplish something, but that is only a phenomenon. It's a very intimately created phenomenon. And so we have a lot of protectiveness. Once consciousness identifies with the body, it begins to protect also the conditioning sometimes for a while. Because having being itself timeless, it became attached to the time body. And so it came into time, then it feels urgency. Many things I have to do and accomplish them. I'm now 35, I'm getting old, it's time to have my children, it's time to... It's got a lot of agendas. Again, when somehow your attention moves back into presence and into being, these concerns are not there. And one finds, but all is well. All is well. And then the mind flares up again, and the feeling comes, no, what am I doing? I mean, I've got things to do, my life is passing by, all my friends are married, have children, and I'm here, you know, hitchhiking around the galaxy, but I'm alone. And you're watching all this play. At some point, you lose also interest is going with that. And something is already in recognition of its own perfect balance and harmony. It's exquisitely happy. So don't try and fulfill any condition like, okay, now I've got to make sure if I can only love the last two. You see, because I have love to all universe, but my neighbor is not easy. Or whatever, you see. And then, oh my God, you know. So don't try to fit into any shape. Just stay only as the awareness. And then you'll see how illusory these intentions are. When you identify with them, they seem vital and they seem important, and I've got to get past this. But again, when the attention rests in presence again, it seems, but my God, what was all that about? It's a kind of madness. There was a madness. And it's gone. If you drink a lot of alcohol, you start to talk alcohol. You sound like alcohol. And it comes with it. And then when it's wore off, then you say, oh. Somebody plays a tape of you talking. You say, my God, that's not me. Thank you, darling. Lovely. Thank you for coming up. Very good.